Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we have this Mercedes C-Class and we're gonna see how good this VDIAG scan tool is to diagnose this car. Of course, we have used many different type of diagnostic tools on our videos, but today we're gonna test this VDIAG, which is VD80, to see how this scan tool is gonna cover all the systems on this Mercedes. This car comes with many different options. That's why I have selected this one today, which is gonna be a great test for this scan tool. This is actually how you get the scanner in this box. This is the VCI itself that can communicate with your scan tool with Bluetooth. And this is the scan tool itself, which comes with a nice touch screen tablet. So we're gonna go on the car to test it. So back in the car, I'm gonna connect the VCI first. All right, VCI is connected to the OBD2 connector. So right here on the main page, we have the auto scan that we can select the car automatically. We have the manual scan. Special functions are here as well. So if you go for the special functions, so right here on special functions, you have a list of special functions that you can select from for the repair that you are working on for different systems, like for oil reset, for electronic parking brake, electronic power steering, injector coating, throttle adaptation, ABS bleeding, and so on. I'm gonna try this scanner later on some other cars to try the special functions too, but today I'm just trying to test the scanner on this car to see how it performs. On the auto scan, so scan tool is communicating with VCI, so it's read all the information that we need. All right, perfect. So some other information that you can select from here. Then we have automatic scan, system selection, a special function again. Let's go for automatic scan. So actually this is one of the good things about this scanner that covers the topology. So as you see, it's trying to scan all the systems on this car. It's scanning everything very quickly, of course, which is really good. So we have already found two fault codes. As you see, these options, they are actually the fault codes that we found. All right, perfect, done. You can actually go for the list of the control units from here, or you can just have a look at the units in a topology diagram, which is of course much easier to find out the control units on different systems like drive, driver assist system, body information, and communication, chassis, air conditioning, and seats and doors. As you see, a scan tool is covering all of them. So basically what you see here, they are the possible control units on this car. If you have the items as green, it means that system is equipped on the car and the scan tool is covering it. The gray ones, it means they are not on this car. They are not installed on this car. We can go on the list to find out the fault codes. So we have one fault code on the head unit, one on the electronic stability program. If I click on the fault code, you have the fault code listed in here. You can erase the fault code quickly by press this one. So the fault code on the head unit is gone, but this one on the ESP is active. That's why we need to fix the car and then we can go for erasing the code. On the system selection, we have all the systems that we can select from. If we go for the drive, you have engine, transmission, fuel system, fuel pump. You have everything regarding the powertrain system. If we go for engine, we have reading and erasing the fault code, freeze frame data, live data, actuation test. If you go for the live data, you can select the live data based on the system that you want. For example, if you go for fuel system, high pressure control, so these are the information that we have on the fuel system, high pressure control. Engine is off, of course. I'm gonna start the engine. We have the engine speed, fuel temperature, rail pressure sensor, and other information related to the fuel system. If you select the live data like engine, fuel temperature, rail pressure, and if you press on record, you can record the information that you are after. So we are recording right now. You can click on the chart as well to have a graph mode. As you see, we have the engine speed, fuel temperature, and rail pressure here in the graph mode. If I increase the engine RPM, as you see, I'm gonna get this kind of graph. You can go for the chart as well to get the graph like this. So not all the scan tools are gonna give you a graph like this. So you see all the information in just one page. So as you see, when I'm increasing the engine RPM, I can read it from here as well. If you go for the actuation test, so this is the actuation test. You can use these items for activating the relevant actuators. For example, if you go for the throttle valve actuator, just make sure that you meet the conditions and engine speed must be less than 50. It means engine must be off. And for continue, you press continue. By pressing F3 and F4, you can actually open or close the throttle valve actuator. And many other actuators, I'm not gonna go for all of them right now. Special functions for the engine can be found here and from the very first page as well. So some other options like coding backup, coding restoration, personalized coding, and control module reset, they are here as well. Not many scan tools cover these options. So if we go back, we're gonna go to the system selections. Let's go for the body control module. So we have all the systems for body control module here. Here, let's go for the airbag system. See how this scan tool is gonna cover the airbag. Reading and erasing the code, let's go for the live data. And so if we go for ignition circuits, airbags of driver and front passengers, so we had all the list of airbags. So as you see, the values for airbags, internal resistance are listed here. This is very important for diagnosing the airbag. So as you see, we are reading the value here. We can select the other airbags as well. This is actually one important factor for diagnosing the airbags. Of course, you can select the other airbags from here as well. Let's go for the seat and doors. See how this scan tool is gonna cover the seat and doors. So electronic seat adjustment on the driver's side. This is exactly where I'm sitting at. On this page, if you go for the actuation test, we have the driver's seat adjustment. So we can actually adjust the driver's seat to go forward and backward. So I'm gonna press the F3. So as you see, driver's seat moves forward just a little because of the safety, because if it goes all the way forward, if someone is sitting right here, it's going to be dangerous. I press it once more. All right. And if we press F4, it's going to go backward. And one more. You can go for testing the other features of the seat and steering column as well. Let's go for the steering column. So if I press on F3, you look at the steering wheel. The steering column moved up. If I press F4, it moved down. Let's go for the right front door right here that I'm sitting at, because this car is right-hand drive. For diagnosing the power window, for example, if you click on the power window itself, so you should be able to have the live data for all switches on the power window. For example, if I try to operate the power window, look at the information here. So as you see, live data is responding properly. And if I go back to the actuation test, I'm gonna have same sections for outside mirror, for the power window. For example, on the power window, right front power window. So F4 is gonna lower the window. All good. And if we press F3, it's gonna go back up. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. This was a review from VDIAG VD80 scan tool. I'm gonna try this scan tool more and more on other cars to see how it really works on other cars too. If you are interested to learn more about this scanner, you can find the link in the video description. And if you want us to review and test other devices, please don't forget to write it in the comment. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video.